Okay, this is video mode here. There we go. You need waterproof signs, okay?
Yeah, we need
to laminate the signs there, all right? You guys got any name tags? So you don't have to put name tags on the outside of your uniform? Whoops.
Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who do not know, fracking has a very effect on us.
Okay, I'm gonna save my.
Can you tell me? Oh, what's your major? Undeclared. Okay.
And
the cap? Are you
fresh?
Yes. Okay. Where are you here today?
Well, I believe that fracking is wrong, and I used to live in the vicinity of a town called Dish, Texas, where there's a bunch of people with like really terrible asthma and really horrible allergies and a bunch of other weird complaints like unusual muscle spasms and all that. So a study was done, and it was found that it was caused by the excessive grass drilling in that area. And considering that they are considering the city wants to put more gas wells into the actual city, that would be quite disastrous considering thousands and thousands of people that live here, that live in this city. And I really don't want to see that happen. I don't want to see people get sick just so some rich corporation can get more money.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my main reason for being here.
Okay, and so is this an organized protest? Did you hear about this, or did you just decide to come out and bring a sign?
It's an organized protest. It's organized to some degree, but, you know, there's a lot of variety in the people who are here.
Uh-huh. And so how did you hear about it?
I heard about it from my friend David, who is not a student.
Uh-huh.
But I just heard about it a few days ago, and I figured, well, you know, I need to go ahead and say my voice and say what I think. So I'm here tonight.
Okay.
Getting cold anyway.
Yeah. And so what do you think should be done differently in Arlington?
I personally think that the city needs to invest in more clean energy, such as wind. if this area was a bit more sunny and had more space solar. But and also to be more environmentally friendly, I think. Also think it needs public transportation. The city needs it badly. To give you an example, I once decided to walk on the mall on I-20, and I live in a car that was 4 miles one way. So I think it's kind of sad that I live in one of the biggest cities of the country, and yet just to go shopping for clothes, I had to walk 4 miles because I don't have a car, I'd rather invest my money in education, and instead I had to walk because I can't get a ride.
Okay. Is there anything else you'd like to say, either about the reason that you're protesting, or maybe a message to the city council?
My message to the city council would be that I have seen the impacts of fracking on the health of people that I know and people that I care about, and that there's really no point in fracking in the first place, that it's just going to make the rich richer at the expense of the public health of citizens of Arlington, Texas.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, thank you very much, John. It was very nice to meet you, and good luck. Try to stay dry.
John, you want Okay, let me get the wet signs before we go inside. There we go, hang on. There we go. Let me get the earth. There we go. Excellent. United States of America, to the Republic, which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have one special presentation tonight, dear friend of mine, dear friend of yours, because he's president of ETA. He's done so much. Would you come down, President?
Long term. beyond 10 to 20 years. We need to think about solar, wind, other truly renewable sources of energy, and not the clean natural gas that Chesapeake likes to sell. And then finally, as one Native American chief once said, only when the last fish has been caught, and the last tree has been cut, and the last river has been poisoned, will we realize that we can't eat money. Thank you very much.
I didn't want to upstage you, you did great.
At the Barron site that not one local, state, or federal entity is set up to test for frack chemicals when we have floods. Similar gaps in protection to the public and our first responders exist, as you will be briefed February 7th by our fire chief in his presentation of needed changes. This 55-acre parcel has lost over half its tag value in 1 year. It was almost $46,000 an acre in 2010 and was lowered to $22,000 an acre. Yet, another parcel, also in the undeveloped status, for example at 4401 Park Springs, is sitting on almost 11 acres. But that owner's paying triple the taxes on $61,000 an acre. Even the city-owned property at Veterans Park at $43,000 an acre is double the tax value than the Rush Creek parcel. The disparity in land value here now makes one wonder if it is by design or desperation to entice a business to come in and coexist near this proposed drill site at bargain basement pricing. I ask council to not vote until it's investigated as to why the land was devalued, and if it had anything to do with the need to have the remaining parcel developed because of the presence of a natural gas production site, then in good faith council should reject this due to the uncertainty in the dry gas play here in North Texas being at its bust stage. Therefore, the reality of drilling actually taking place is questionable. And in my opinion, this owner is effectively getting a tax break when others aren't. Proof of property devaluation associated with drill sites has never been so apparent as in this case. I have an attorney, Tyler attorney, Blake Bailey, who's taken participants in a fracking class action lawsuit.
I'm a member of OccupyNow and a representative of Indian Deval Tribes Coalition. We've heard a lot about the arguments for fracking has been for convenience. Even the ones against fracking has been for convenience. People are worried about the noise, the traffic, all of this, and they're not worried about the health and safety of the children of Arlington. Let me remind you that yes, maybe when you're thinking of oil and natural gas may be the lesser of two evils. But it is choosing the lesser of two evils that ended up in disaster in Washington, D.C., and it's that same mentality that will end up in disaster in Arlington. Let me remind you, this is something that hasn't been touched on, is that there are large portions of Arlington, members of Unitarian Universalists, members of the neo-pagan community, and members of the Native American community that see the earth as a religious symbol, as a sacred element. And by choosing to destroy and rape what we see as sacred, you are blatantly disregarding our First Amendment right to freedom of religion. Let me remind you that no member of the Native American community, neo-pagan community, or Unitarian Universalist community goes into your community and destroys your churches. We respect your religion. We ask you to do the same for us. We implore you to not allow this to continue. Not only here in Arlington, but do everything you can to prevent fracking and drilling everywhere. But if you don't, if you allow this to pass, then I give you my word. From the Native American community, the Occupy movement, the Unitarian Universalist community, that we will not stand by while you turn your back on the people of Arlington. We will not stand by while you turn your back on the children of Arlington, and we will not allow you to destroy what is sacred to us.
Where is he from?
Roosevelt Street.
Thank you, Pete.
Good evening.
policy, and I'm here to politely ask you to reconsider this project and consider alternative sources of energy in which are abundant, self-sufficient, and have become more self-evident in the past decades. Alternative sources in which are actually cleaner for our own planet. Today we have the technological capability to give an abundance of clean energy without drilling or going to war. I understand that alternative sources of energy will allow my children to live in a clean and more sustainable environment. So, you have to ask yourselves, are we really doing our best? Are we really advancing for the better of the human race and our planet? Or are we just going to continue suffering from a disease caused by the current paradigm of the profit incentive? Remember, we have not an energy crisis, nor a political crisis. We have an ignorance crisis. So what the frack should we do? We for a better world.
Two points.
Undermining voting since it won't happen.
Okay, motion, and I'll second that motion. Deny.
Yes, vote to deny.
Yeah, yes, vote.
Okay, now we want to see green apparently.
So this is a vote to deny. Vote.